جايين من كل مكان للصورة زينة البلدان زورون رجع فرحان
دريز הפסוק הוא סד, תשובה ישראל עד השם אלוקיך. That means, תשובה ישראל את הקדוש ברוך הוא, he said that a Jew has, a Yehudi has a chance to do תשובה. And you know that to do תשובה it's not easy. Especially when, let's say, somebody who hurt somebody else, somebody has shalom who did a big avera. How can he correct this avera that he did or he threw doing tishava? He's a big rab who said, Maran Rabbi Yosef, alav shalom, he said, imagine somebody killed somebody, and he killed somebody. How can you do Teshuvah? What about this person that he killed? How it's possible? Can you put him alive again, this person? So what is Teshuvah? Somebody who has shalom, he smoke on Shabbat. Well, do Teshuvah, and that she forgive you. How? Once he did the damage, how can you do Teshuvah? This is a question that... Maran Rabbi Yosef asked. For this, I was thinking, there is a, the Gemara said, a person who do Avera and he does Teshuvah, we compare him to Nolad Dami. That means it's like he's a newborn. That means if you say it's like a newborn, that means that he never did Avera. Finished. He did it before. Mish Jose Bitshuva cannot dame. It's like a ger. Somebody who was a goy and become ger, he covered. It's like he was born now. So the same with a Baal Tshuva. A Baal Tshuva who behemet Tshuva Israel ad Hashem Elokecha. But the Pasuk said, the prophet said, ad Hashem Elokecha. That means that should be a real teshuvah. Ad Hashem Elokecha. It's not just Teshuvah Israel. No. Ad Hashem Elokecha. The teshuvah should be b'emet till you connect yourself to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. There is another pasuk who said, Banim Atem Lashem Elokechem. Banim Atem Lashem Elokechem. You are the children of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So, as you know, a father always forgives. A father always forgives. So if Hashem compares Am Israel like his children, so he's a father. So if you do something bad, and we say, Papa, excuse me, so he forgives. Before we said, how it's possible somebody who does a Avera, how it's possible that he can correct it? It's supposed he did something bad. How can you know when you repair something? Usually, when we talk about material, you repair a car or you repair something, a damage, always still a mark. It's not a brand new. It was brand new, but see the accident. Even if you repair it, it's not a brand new. It's still always a mark. If you have to sell it, it's a second hand. It's not something new. But the difference, this is when we talk about material. But when you talk about a man who was doing averot and he did teshuvah, ad Hashem Elokecha, he become brand new. And not even that, we compare him more than a tzaddik. Where there is a Baal Teshuvah, even a tzaddik, you cannot, even as a tzaddik, you cannot stand next to him, because a Baal Teshuvah, with the Teshuvah, it becomes so new So Mamash become more than a tzaddik, because always I have experience with Baal Teshuvah. I have experience with them. Always I see the Baal Teshuvah, they have a lot of Yirat Shamayim. This is the truth. I see Avrichim, I see Rabbis, I see Rosh Yeshivot. But Baal Teshuvah, I see them, how they pray. But when I say Baal Teshuvah, the way he prays, the way he acts, the way he behaves, it's something... A lot of times I'm jealous of them. Baby, so a lot of times I'm jealous of them. I'm jealous of their Yirat Shamayim. And sometimes I say to myself, on the other hand, Baruch Hashem, that I don't have a past like them. But on the other hand, I say they're Yirat Shamayim. How they? I'm jealous of them. I say, I wish I could be like them, but without being a Chas V'Shalom Rasha to do a Teshuvah. Baby, this is the emet. I would like to ask you something. You know what you do today? Those days till Be'ezrat Hashem, till Hoshana Rabba, till Kippur, Hoshana Rabba. We, the Torah said, Tik'o b'chodesh Shuvah. B'kei Se'elim Hagino. You know that when Hashem judged Am Yisrael, it's fabulous Hashem. It's fantastic. When he judged Am Yisrael, he don't usually, the judge, when he judged somebody, he judged him in front of people, in front of lawyers, in front of his enemies. But Le'avdil, when HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he judged Am Yisrael, b'kesi liyom hagino. It's incredible. On the one hand, we do simcha hagino, it's a hag. On the other hand, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, how can a person, when he's sitting or standing in front of a judge, it's impossible that he will be happy. It's impossible. A man that he received, you know, a letter from the judge that they accuse him for a lot of things, and they ask him to come, and they give him a day to come. I mean, that person, he will not eat for all week. He will be afraid. Especially the member that is in front of the judge, maybe he can faint, maybe he can have a heart attack. But the Torah said, "Bakesi liyom hagino." We are Israel, on Rosh Hashanah, we are happy. We are happy. Hagino. Ki chok li Israel hu, mishpat li Elohi Yaakov. Hashem judge Am Israel, why he judged them, we are happy. You know why? Because of Bakesi. Because when HaKadosh Baruch Hu judge us, he don't judge us in front of us. Bakesi. Yeah. It's in a room that there is nobody there. Kisui. Hakol Mechuse. There is no bad malachim who attend that judgment. And besides it, look how much Hashem is. He's so nice. Hashem, he gave us a mitzvah of shofar, that we blow the shofar. Tik'o b'chodesh shofar. B'kesei liyom hagino. Tik'o b'chodesh shofar. And as you know, according to the Zohar Kadosh, or the Holy Sfarim said, that when we blow the shofar, the malachim are afraid. There is a lot of meaning in the shofar. It's a gzeret ha-katuv. Hashem give us this mitzvah of shofar, that at the moment that the logic is, when you see a policeman, you're afraid of him. So if you go fast, you slow down because of the police. So Hashem did that the malachim are afraid of the shofar. For them, the shofar, it's something very, very dangerous for them. So when we blow the shofar, the malachim, you see here, the malachim are here. Hashem is the shofet, the judge, and the malachim are here. What we do? Tikhu. We blow the shofar. What happened? The malachim are afraid. They go. So who is left? Hashem. Hashem is judged Am Israel alone. There is no mikatregim. There is no bad malachim. There is nobody. So of course, please listen to this. If there is no malachim, there is nobody. So that means we become clean. No averot. Nothing left. That is a chesed from HaKadosh Baruch that he gives us teshuvah. But the teshuvah should be Shuvah Yisrael Ad Hashem Elokecha. Of course, in Yom Kippur, people do teshuvah. But of course, they prepare themselves, they did kaparot, they did a lot of things. But is there teshuvah? It's led them to be next to Hashem. Are they now connected to Hashem? If it's yes, so the teshuvah, it's good. But if they feel that still they have ta'avot, they have advised, or they want to do averot, that means they did teshuvah, but they're not connected to Hashem. I said to somebody today, he told me, Rabbi, do you think my teshuvah, it was a good teshuvah that I did this? You know, Rosh Hashanah, do you think? I wanted to tell him, how do I know? Do I think? I said, one thing I tell you. If you think that the averot that you did before, that you did teshuvah for them, you have itzara to do them, that means you did not do teshuvah. If still you have the ta'ava invite to do averot, so your teshuvah is. But it's behemet. You don't feel it. You feel that Baruch Hashem, you are strong, and you have no invite to do averot. That means that your teshuvah, she went to the Shamaim, and you are connected to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Because it's impossible. If you are connected to Hashem, it's impossible to do averot. It's impossible. Mamash apidecha tevaitza. It's not real. It's impossible. So the only way, behemet, if you want to, this is an experience. I mean, do this experience. If behemet you still feel the same like before, that means there is a problem. But if you feel a change, moy at shamayim, so that means there is no problem. The Gemara said, the Midrash said when Moshe Rabbeinu, he went to the Shamaim to ask from Hashem forgiveness to Am Yisrael and to bring the second Luchot HaBrit. During 40 days, the Bnei Israel, they blow the shofar every day. They started from Rosh Chodesh Elul till Yom Kippur, 40 days. Why they blow the shofar? Because they were afraid, Chas v'Shalom, that they will do again the Egel. They were afraid. Why Moshe Rabbeinu is the Shamaim? That again they will do the Egel. So what they did, every day from the day that he went to the Shamaim, they blow the shofar. Till Yom Kippur, when he arrived. I asked to myself, how it's possible that I understand the first time they did what they did. But the second time, how it's possible that you think that Am Israel, Chas v'Shalom, God forbid, that they blow the shofar every day, and every day they do teshuvah, because if they don't count away, they will do again the Egel. I mean, they forgot that Hashem wanted to kill them, to destroy them. The answer is, from here you see, the koach of the Yitzhara. When you have when already you felt one day in the end of the Zahara, there is no guarantee that you will not fail again. There is no guarantee. So you have to be always, always awake. Always you have to be given. You know, in the month of Elul, there is Rabbeinu Yonah, Alav Shalom, he said Shari Tshuva. How much a person should be afraid from the Rosh Chodesh Elul till Yom Kippur? Do we feel it? I'll tell you something. When I was in Morocco, when I was young, we felt Elul. Damn it. When Elul came, we felt Elul. We were afraid of the month of Elul. We heard Slichot everywhere. We heard Shofar everywhere. Well, Jews used to live in the Melah, you know, around. And you see people going to Shul. They made you feel. I remember I was six year old. I left Israel, I left Morocco when I was 9 year old. I remember, Baruch Hashem, I have a good memory. We felt Elul, we could smell Elul. He said, like when you smell the children has a special flavor. This Elul, we felt it. We felt Elul. Why not today? Why not today? Last Shabbat, when we were in Morocco, in Issaouira, we went to synagogue where a few hundred people walk in the Mela. It was the 25th of Elul on Shabbat. Not only we felt Shabbat, but we felt Elul. You know why? Because we were in the Mela. The Ashpa of the Melah. The Melah is the ghetto. The Ashpa. There is no Jews now in the Melah. But because 50 years ago the Jews lived there and they did there, the Slichot, we feel that Kedusha. Bemet, this is the truth. You can imagine what the difference between before and today. You know what? Because before, we did not have things to look, to see. We had Tarat Ainaim. Our eyes were clean. There was nothing to see. Today, unfortunately, we live in New York. We live in Paris. We live in London. Today, unfortunately, we see bad things. Even that we don't look to look at them. But eventually, you live in a world of its era. And that's why that stops you feeling this kind of feeling of Elul, the Yamim Noraim. In the time of Rabbi Yisrael Salanter, Alav Shalom, he said that everybody knows that Rabbi Yisrael Salanter, he had a beautiful rhythm. He writes very, very, very well. But on Elul, he couldn't write well. So they asked him, why you don't write well? He said, it's Elul. He had the fear of Elul. This is, you understand? That's unfortunately today. But still, Baruch Hashem, today, it's up to us. Because Baruch Hu give us this month. Well, the Ikar is, do as you can. Hashem, he don't ask you to be a tzaddik. Do your best. Now I help you. I was so happy today and yesterday to see a lot of people. A lot of times I ask people, well, how was Rosh Hashanah? How was good? Well, I did not hear a person telling me the food was good. Everybody told me I was in shul. We prayed. And now we have people coming. That means that they feel it. They feel it. The Yeshua Hashem be Matzo be Yotokarov. Because Hashem is by, is near. So you feel him. It's like a perfume. When there is somebody who put perfume in him, on him, you smell the perfume. So today we smell this Kiddushah of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. That he's like, he proclaim, hey, I'm the king. Hey, smell me. Come near me. The Yeshua Hashem be Matzo, be Yotokarov. So, my friend, I would like just to finish and to remind you what the Baal Musa said. That Elul is the word of Lul. Lul, it's a. Lul, it's like a cage. A cage where there is there where you put chickens. Lul. Elul. You know where we put chickens in the cage? Because you take it to the shochet. You collect the chickens, you put them in a cage. So Elul, it's like, good for you, Has you shalom, we are in a cage. And if you are in a cage, no one knows which one the shochet will choose. The shochet is here. The cage is here. And the shochet is going to take it, put his hand and you know, inside the cage. Which one is going to take? Which one he will escape from the hand of the shochet? This is Elul. So in Elul, we are in danger. I mean, one of us is going to go. But maybe no one will go. Why? Because maybe the shochet he will decide not to kill not chickens. So this is Elul. No one knows. No one has a guarantee who is going to live next year. But we have emuna on Hashem. With tshuva, with tzedaka, with tzom, ma'avirim ro'a gzera. The tshuva, the tzedaka, and kippur take out the gzera. And of course, how much all of us should do be'ezrat Hashem some commitment to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, because tshuva, it's like Hashem, please forgive me what I did before. Thank you. Okay, I forgive you. So what you will do today, what your commitment, I will not do it again. How can you know that you will not do it again? So you need a second commitment. Limud HaTorah. When you commit yourself to study Torah Be'ezrat Hashem, that helps you not to commit Averot and Be'ezrat Hashem. Do Yehi Ratzon Shekadosh Baruch Hu Ten Lachem Berakha Ve'Hatzlacha בבריאות ועת השם, בשנה הטובה תכתבו ותחתמו לחיים טובים ושלום, בריאות הגוף ועת השם, בשורות טובות. זה בחברה כאן שאומר, עשה את השורות צריך להתראות, לבגר היבן לתור שואר נחפץ, למעט צדקו ילדי תורה וידיר. You know what I said, you know what I said before? I said, what that mean, the word חוזר בתשובה? Hozer, that means I go back. What does that mean? I go back to where? He said, Hozer b'tshuva. What do you mean? Hozer, I go back. We see the word Hozer is I go back. Go back where? So, of course, Rabotai, go back backward. That means a man who do teshuva, if a man do teshuva, so Hashem what he did. What he does, Hashem, he take this man and he put him, if a man, he did a sin here, in this place. So what Hashem did, so Hashem, he turned our backward and he took him to a place, to the time before he did the Avera. So that means there was no Avera. That this is the meaning, Hozer, this is Bitshuva. Teshuvah is the word answer. What it is the answer? How Hashem can accept the teshuvah of somebody? The answer is when you do teshuvah, Kadosh Baruch Hu, it takes you back to the place before you did the avera. So Be'ezrat Hashem, Yehi Ratzon Shenizkeh SheHakadosh Baruch Hu Yikach Otanu BeHazara LaMakom. שלפני שעשיתי העבירה. אז אין עבירה. זה שיש משמור אתכם.
بنتو وقف لنا زي خوف.